Hello everyone. Welcome to this Bold Reports tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to create an ASP.NET Core Web API reporting service application for Report Viewer. If you want to build a reporting application with a centralized reporting service, using ASP.NET Core Web API with Bold Report Viewer is a great choice. This combination offers a robust and centralized solution for report processing, efficiently generating and delivering reports across multiple platforms while managing data effectively. Additionally, it provides flexibility for hosting in various environments, including Kestrel, IIS, HTTP.sys, Nginx, and Docker. Let me show you how to create an ASP.NET Core Web API reporting service application using Visual Studio Code. First, to create an application, run this command. Name the project, Core API Service. Once the application is created, navigate to the application's root folder by changing the current working directory. Next, to install the necessary NuGet packages to the application. First, I will add the boldreports.net.core package by running this command. This package includes all the dependencies required to add the Bold Reports report viewer. Then, I create a resources folder in the www root folder to store the RDL reports. For this video, I will use the salesorderdetails.rdl file that is already available in my computer. And add this file to the resources folder. The salesorderdetails.rdl file's download link is in this video's description. After adding the sample report to the application, I must configure the web API. So, I create a new controller file named reportviewercontroller.cs, to which I need to add all the necessary using statements as references, declare the required namespaces, and define the classes. First, I add the boldreports.web.reportviewer namespace, which provides the class and interfaces specific to the Bold Reports library and is used to configure and manage the report viewer. Next, add the microsoft.aspnetcore.mvc namespace to the controller file, which allows you to build the web application, including web APIs, while providing essential features like routing and model binding. Next, add the microsoft.aspnetcore.hosting namespace, which provides types for configuring and running web applications. I add the microsoft.extensions.caching.memory namespace, which enables in-memory caching capabilities to store and retrieve data quickly. Finally, add the system.io namespace, which is essential for input-output operations, such as reading from and writing to data streams and files. To avoid naming conflicts, add the core-api-service.controllers namespace. Inside the report viewer controller, add the root attribute to define the controller's root. I also add the microsoft.aspnetcore.cores.enablecores attribute, which is used in ASP.NET Core applications to enable cross-origin resource sharing for a specific controller, action, or endpoint. Next, inherit the controller and implement the iReportController interface in the reportViewerController class to handle the viewing of reports. The iReportController interface declares the action methods for processing reports and handling resource requests within the Web API controller. To read the report file from the application, I utilize the iWebHosting environment interface through dependency injection to access the web root path. Then, I add the post-report action method to process report requests from the server side. This method takes a JSON parameter and sends the response back to the client side using the HTTP post action. Next, I implement the onInitReportOptions method, which the report helper invokes when the report is about to be processed during the preview. Inside this method, I need to load the report as a stream. So, I create a base path variable to combine the web root path of the application and resources folder. Then, I create a report path variable to combine the base path and report name using reportOption.reportModel.reportPath to access the available report. I create a file stream instance to open the RDL report file in the resources folder within the www root directory using the report path variable. Then, I create a memory stream to store the report data and copy the file stream. This copy process prevents file access problems in the server when running the application. Finally, I assign the memory stream values to the report option.reportModel.stream variable. Next, I add the onReportLoaded method, which a report helper invokes when the report and its subreports start loading for rendering. Next, implement the GetResource method to retrieve images used in the report from the server when previewing the report in the designer. The action name GetResource and accept verbs get attributes specify the endpoint and HTTP verb for accessing these resources. Next, add the postFormReportAction method to save the exported report to the client side using the HTTP post action. Finally, I need to register the license token to remove the license validation message. In this demo, I am going to use the online license token. License tokens can be generated in the Claim License Key section of the Bold Reports Accounts page. So, open the program.cs file and add the code to register the token. I have provided a link to the documentation on registering a license using online license tokens and offline license keys in this video's description. Then, to allow access to the web API service from a different domain, enable cross-origin requests. To implement the add cores method in the service container, add the following code snippet to the service's configuration and call the useCores method in the app's middleware pipeline. Now, everything is ready to run the application. I execute the command, and a URL is generated. Next, I need to verify that the created ASP.NET Core Web API application functions correctly. To do this, I create a simple JavaScript HTML application and adding the report viewer control. This localhost URL is same as the URL in which the report service is running, and the API/reportViewer path is the API endpoint for the reportViewer service. The video's description includes a video link on creating an HTML application with the reportViewer control. I run this application. The sales order details report renders successfully, confirming that the core web API service application functions properly. In this video, I have shown you how to create an ASP.NET Core Web API reporting service application for Report Viewer. If you found this video useful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.